Hey babes, welcome to the Happiness Heals channel. My name is Miss T. If you're new here, welcome. And if you're returning, welcome back. Today we're doing an estimated budget using my paycheck bill tracker for an upcoming payday on July 24th, 2020. I'm going to be putting together my estimated budget using the budget column for the week, and then I'll come back next week with my payday budget and make any adjustments before I actually spend my money. I like to start with my income for the payday, and before I do that, let me write in the date. We're starting with the payday on July 24th, 2020, and then we jump over here to the income category. So for this pay period, I'm expecting my regular paycheck, which is $2,914.62 estimated. And then I'm also expecting my savings that automatically roll over to my savings account, which is $50. I will also have my pension payment, which occurs on the first of the month, and that is for $42.67. I don't think I'll have any rollover fund for this pay period, so I'm gonna estimate that at zero. If for some reason I do, I will add that to my actual column on my payday. So let me add up what my estimated income will be for this pay period. $3,007.29. Now, in terms of bills for this pay period, I do have quite a bit that I need to add in. So I have my student loan, which is due on the 24th, and that is for $371.79. And then I have a red light ticket, I think it is, from recently, and that is also due on the 24th for $100. I hate those red light cameras. And I have storage, $724, and that is for $155. And I have my car note, and that is for $405.25. I just recently upgraded my daughter's cell phone, so she has a plan with Verizon now, and that is due on the 29th. Verizon is $199.57. Now I'm going to add the August payments that are associated with this pay period. I have one official payment that needs to be made, and that is for my Credit One credit card. I did pay it off in full in July, but there is a annual fee that is broken down monthly, and I think a little bit of interest that was also charged to me. That bill is due on the 5th of August, and that is for $10.88. I also have a John Hopkins medical payment that is due on the 5th as well, and that is for $30. That came in the mail, so that's why it's being treated like a bill rather than my regular copays when we go in and visit our doctors. Those are the bills that are associated with this pay period. I do have some things that need to go in with variable expenses, but I'll get to those when I get to that section. So let me add these up and see what my total for bills are. My total for my bills is $1,272.49. In order to find out how much I have left over after my bills, I'm going to subtract my bill total from my income. So $3,007.29 minus $1,272.49 equals $1,734.80 is left over. Let me jump over to sinking funds, extra debt, and extra savings. If you watch my videos, you know my method is a little bit different from the Budget Mom because I focus in on paying my sinking funds, extra debt, and extra savings, and whatever I have left over goes into variable expenses, and then I divvy that up into my various expenses for that category. So I'm going to jump over to sinking funds, and as you know, last month I literally literally had to pretty much zero out my most significant sinking funds. I had saved up quite a bit from January to July, but I really needed to make a big payment for a settlement that was very important to getting myself on a clear path with my financial journey. So I'm restarting several of my sinking funds, including Christmas 2020, and I want to make sure that I allocate a good amount to those to get me through the year. So I have Christmas 2020 as one of my sinking funds. I also have created a few new sinking funds that I also want to make sure I include. For instance, one for my daughter since she'll be away at school and making sure that she has expenses covered. My car insurance, pet expenses, memberships. Travel, I want to add to that one because I'm going to use some of that to pay for our trip to Rochester. For Christmas 2020, set aside $110. For my daughter, I'm going to set aside $50 for that. And then for car insurance, I know I do have a large payment coming up in August to renew it. I'll put $295 towards that. And then pet expenses, I put $40. Memberships, I put $25. Travel, I'm going to put $100. Car maintenance, $20. And business, $25. So let me add up what my sinking fund totals will be for this pay period. Equals $665 for sinking funds. Now I'm going to come down to extra debt. I want to make my Navient payment an even $400. So let me figure out what the difference is for that. I need to add $28.21 to get Navient to $400. I also want to add an extra $100 to my Wells Fargo payment. Actually, maybe I'll just do an extra $50 this pay period because I'm still trying to build things back up slowly. I don't want to overwhelm myself or my budget. So let me go with $50 for that. Actually, I think those are my two only extra debt payments I need to make this pay period. It equals $78.21. And then extra savings. So I want to put some in my checking cushion, my savings cushion, my emergency fund, and my savings challenges. Actually, I don't have to budget anything in specifically for my savings challenges. My emergency fund, I want to do $125 for that. $50 towards my savings cushion, $25 towards my checking cushion. Let me add up what that shall be, $200. Now I'm going to take the totals from my sinking funds, extra debt, and extra savings, subtract them from my leftover amount, and that will tell me how much I have for variable expenses. That leaves me with $791.59. For variable expenses this pay period, I have groceries, dining out, medical, pet, gas, car wash, charity, Ashley dorm, and miscellaneous. And then if I have anything left over, I will put it towards shopping. I doubt it though, because this looks like I've allocated a lot there. Right off the bat, I know that I need to allocate some money for my dog because he has upcoming appointments this pay period. I'm going to allocate $300 to him. And any additional will come from our sinking fund. For medical, we have quite a few copays. I did see that my daughter has three the first few weeks of August. Actually, my daughter has two and I have one. So I'm going to set aside $100 for medical. For dining out, I'll do $150. For groceries, I don't have a whole lot that I plan to purchase for the next pay period. So I'll just go with $120. For gas car wash, we will do $40. It's not leaving us with a whole lot to work with, actually. I will definitely have to rethink some of these priorities by my payday. And then charity, let's say $20 for that. That literally does not leave me anything extra to put towards my daughter's dorm expenses. And miscellaneous would just leave us with $61.59. So with my current estimated budget. Things will be pretty tight for us with variable expenses. I'm not really sure if I'm comfortable with things being that tight because, for one, I know I need to put some money towards my daughter's dorm expenses. We have quite a few things we still need to purchase in preparation for that. I think I will be rearranging some of these other expenses, things I would like to do versus what I actually can do. And you'll see those changes on my payday budget. I need to think through where I want to allocate some of these other things. But that at least gives me an idea of what I need to cover for this upcoming payday, which gives me anxiety if I put it off too long. So I'm glad that I was able to get that done and use both my July budget calendar as well as my August budget calendar to help me get those things done. I will put links to both of those calendars in the description in case you're interested in seeing how I put them together. And if you like this video, and hopefully it did inspire you a little bit to work on your particular payday budget, then please give it a thumbs up. Also, make sure you hit the subscribe button as well as the notification bell so you'll be informed the very next time we have something to share on the Happiness Heals channel. Ciao!